No, this way. Follow me, won't you? What? Beg your pardon? Why, of course I'm Mother Goose. Do you know any other mother who flies about on a goose one? Ah, I thought not. Well, come along now. It's quite proper to fly, if you can. You might say it's a bit wacky where I come from, but who knows? You might find yourself doing some things you've never done before. As a matter of fact, I'm sure you'll like it. Just open your mind and give it a good old try. This way. Delia. Oh, there. Welcome to the wacky world of me, Mother Goose. I'm so glad you took my advice and decided to come along. Oh, sorry, Bedelia. I almost forgot. You must keep up your strength now, mustn't we? I do hope you'll like it here. It's really quite a pleasant place. Now, everybody happy and gay again. Nothing to do all day but play games and sing songs. Oh, but it wasn't always this way, you know. Oh, dear me, no. I should say not. We had a terrible time a few years ago. Simply awful. Actually, it was quite exciting. It all started when I had to leave Mother Goose Land to visit my sister, who'd suddenly come down with a bad, bad head cold. I knew just what she needed. A nice pot of hot magic soup. Delicious. sir?
'Tis myself, the baker man.
Ah, Paddy Cake. You all know him.
Paddy Cake, baker's man. Bake a cake as fast as you can.
And these ought to help your sister to feel better. I made them extra special good.
I'm certain they'll do splendidly.
Ah, but you'll be so far away. Your sister lives way beyond the moon.
Now. I've left everything in charge of old King Cole.
And a fine, merry old soul he is, too. But begging your pardon, ma'am, he's just a king, an ordinary mortal. He has no magic powers to protect us the way you do.
But why should you need protection?
Oh, there's been all kinds of evil omens.
Omens?
Aye, omens. Didn't the east wind come out of the north t'other day? And with me own eyes, I saw a cow eating acorns and a squirrel munching oats. And just yesterday, I baked an upside-down cake. And when I took it out of the oven, it was right side up.
Oh, stuff and nonsense. That's just silly superstition. Oh, my goodness. I'd best be on my way. I've a long trip ahead of me, and it's almost 1 o'clock. I said it's almost one. Oh, that lazy clock. Hickory dickory, wake up your friend.
Hickory dickory dock, the mouse ran up the clock. The clock struck one and down he ran. Hickory dickory dock.
That's better. Now I must be on my way.
Can I help you pack?
No, nothing to it. Come here now. Now keep that soup nice and hot.
Magic powers. Wonderful to behold.
Yes, they do come in handy every once in a while. Goodbye, Mother Goose. Come back soon. We love you. And goodbye to you, Jack Horner.
Here, ma'am. It's my Christmas pie. You take it, so you'll have something to eat on the way.
Why, thank you, Jack, but I have plenty to eat. You enjoy it yourself.
Oh, Mother Goose, it's gonna be terrible with you gone.
Don't tell me you've had omens also.
Uh-huh. Last night, when I did my homework, I added up 2 and 2, and it came out 5. And then my dog said, meow. And a bird went woof, woof, and...
Jack, I'm surprised at you. You're letting your imagination run away. King Cole will take care of you all.
Yes, ma'am.
And now I really must be off. Why do I always cry when I have to say goodbye? Why can't I leave without weeping, without a tear in my eye? Why do I always cry when I have to say goodbye? Why can't I depart and not leave my heart behind? Goodbye is the saddest word in my vocabulary. My tongue gets thick and furry when I have to utter it. I can only stutter it. Now, Miss Muffet, get off that tuffet and eat your curds and whey. And Jack and Jill, be careful when you climb that hill today. Poor simple Simon, save that penny. Jack Sprat, I hope you don't eat any fat. And Mrs. Sprat, no lean, and no pickled peppers in between. Peter, give me the pickled pepper, Peter. They're bad for your digestion, without question. They'll spoil your taste for Christmas pie. Pie. Oh, I simply detest any word that rhymes with goodbye. Oh, why do I always cry when I have to say goodbye? Why can't I grin and just bear it and say au revoir, ta-ta, so long, goodbye? There I go again. Goodbye. Goodbye. Farewell, my friends. I'm off to beyond the moon. I'll be back someday. Oh, I hated to leave them, but I did think they were in good hands. If only I had known. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Whoop. Hey, be careful.
I'm starting to lose my balance. That's a bad omen.
There's been too many bad omens lately.
I know. Yesterday, I saw smoke going down the chimney. Whoops! I have a feeling something terrible is about to happen.
I wish now I'd paid attention to their omens. But little did I know that Count Warptwist, the crooked man who'd just come to live in our kingdom, was a cruel and evil villain at heart.
And a crooked man and a crooked heart, and he lived in a very crooked house.
This is the opportunity I have been waiting for. With Mother Goose out of the picture, her subjects are sitting ducks to me. Ducks, Goose. Yes, I have powers too. Evil powers.
Your bidding is my command, Count Warptwist.
Of course, my powers aren't as strong as hers, but she is gone now. And soon the land of Mother Goose will be the land of the crooked Count Warptwist. Zigzag! Where is my stupid squire? Zigzag!
Yes, Count Whipworth. Mr. Worp, Gertfist.
Quiet, dolt. We must move swiftly. Ring the gong and call my crooked knights to council.
Aye, aye, Count Twistwist, work for it.
Ring the gong!
Aye, aye. Ouch! Yes, sir, I'm gonging the ring. Ringing the gong? Yes, sir. I missed.
Don't let me do it.
And so the booming gong rang out over the countryside. And from every terrible, forgotten place imaginable, there emerged an ugly army of evil, crooked knights. Heartless brutes who owed allegiance to but one man, Count Warptwist.
Council chamber. Council chamber. Step lively. Just kidding. This way. Oh, hail. Oh, hail. The crooked nobleman of darkness. His supreme awfulness, Count Twiprump. Twipmist. Liverwurst.
Don't.
Oh, what's his name? You know.
No! All hail, Count Warptwist!
Hail to thee, crooked knights of the Twisted Garter!
Hail! Hail! Hail!
What kind of knights are we?
We're the knights of the Twisted Garter. We're crooked knights. How's that for a starter?
Our deeds shall be...
Dire!
You're playing with...
Fire!
If you cross our path, you'll know our wrath.
We're the knights of the Twisted Garter.
We're crooked knights.
Bad guys. Worse than that, real bad guys.
Attila the Hun was a peach compared to me. Let's hear it for me.
Hiss! Boo! Boo! Hiss!
It's wonderful to be loved. Now that Mother Goose is gone, we shall take over the land. We must act swiftly. My plans are laid. The first job is to put King Cole out of commission.
How do we do that, oh great crooked one?
We capture his beautiful daughter, the fair Princess Harmony. If her life, her very existence is threatened, old King Cole will be blackmailed into doing whatever we want.
Old King Cole was a merry old soul, and a merry old soul was he.
My pipe, my bow, my fiddle and string. Where is my daughter, the beautiful Princess Harmony?
She's making herself especially beautiful for you this evening.
Not for me, I'll wager. It's for young Prince Robin, who sups with us this evening.
Ah, here she comes now, Your Majesty.
Rings on her fingers, bells on her toes. She shall have music wherever she goes.
Father, dear?
My darling Princess Harmony, will you sing for me?
What song, Father? Oh, may I sing a love song? For my heart is overflowing with love for my brave Prince Robin.
Robin? Who is he?
Why, Father, he's the handsomest prince in all the world. See? Oh, Father, you're teasing me.
Yes, my darling, then sing a love song, for I do see the light of love in your eyes.
I still believe in fairy tale romance, storybook love, and strawberry dreams. I know that it seems naive, but I believe in make-believing. I close my eyes and see you in armor, my shining knight. It's love at first sight. I know that it might seem strange, but I believe in rosy dreaming. I can blow out the moon if I try. I can build a castle. So save yourself the trouble. I'll still believe in fairy tale romance, storybook love, and strawberry dreams. And someday I'll prove to you that fairy tale romance, storybook love, and strawberry dreams
just sings for me alone.
Doggone.
Oh, gee whiz. Hey, step aside, fellas. I'm late enough as it is. Ah, come on, guys. I'm a prince. Hey, that's not very nice.
Now bring him over to Count Warp Twist.
Another!
Oh, please, Father, no. I must save my voice until Prince Robin arrives. Where can he be? Oh!
Fair princess, I must see you alone! Come out on the parapet, and I will climb up to thee!
But why?
Do not ask questions! It's important you do as I ask!
Very well.
We've got her. Now old King Cole is in the palm of our hands.
Where?
Don't! Now to present our proposition. Won't this be a tasty dish to set before the king?
Come no further.
We wish. Wish, I say. Nay, we demand to see the king.
Nay, demand.
Quiet.
The king cannot possibly see you.
The king cannot see us? The king cannot see us? Zigzag, did you ever hear anything so amusing in your life?
Yes.
What?
I mean, no. Not in my life. Not in your life.
Oh, shut up. I demand to see the king.
The king is in seclusion.
We'll just have to look for him there.
Where?
In seclusion.
Zigzag?
Which way to seclusion?
Will you please?
You get a map.
Shut up!
Be gone, riffraff.
Riffraff? Riffraff? I shall show you who is riffraff. Men!
That looks like fun.
Help! Help!
No fair splashing now.
Will you shut up and follow me? Onward!
Halt! Go no further.
And who may you be?
We are the king's knights.
Stupid oafs! I'll show you what you're up against. Take this! King's Knights, eh? Not anymore, you're not. From now on, you are Crooked Knights.
All hail Count Warp Twist!
Now, where is that fool? I refer, of course, to the jolly old soul.
What's going on here? Have you gentlemen come to see me?
Hey, what do you know? He's back. How is the weather out there in seclusion?
Quiet, dolt!
Here. What is the meaning of this intrusion? Dear.
Oh, here. Dear.
Oh, your majesty, you must forgive our terrible manners. Whatever could we have been thinking of?
terrible.
Oh, it's quite all right. My pipe, my bowl, my fiddler.
Not now.
I beg your pardon?
I said not now.
He said, not now.
Oh, gee whiz. Something tells me all's not well here. Oh, don't do that.
I shall do anything I please around here from now on.
Me too.
Shut up!
Now, see here. You don't frighten me. I'm really very brave. Down deep.
Well, perhaps you are not frightened for yourself, but there are others in your royal family.
Others? There are no others in my family, except for the Princess Harmony. Harmony! What have you done to my daughter?
Harmony is my prisoner, and if you do not obey my commands, terrible things will happen to her.
I'll do anything, anything you say.
First of all, give me the royal diamond and gold mines.
They are yours.
And issue a proclamation. All able-bodied men and women shall become my slaves. No, that's too strong. My subjects. And they can be commandeered to work in the mines.
No!
Then you shall never see Harmony again.
Yes, very well. I am powerless.
Oh, that terrible, terrible Count Warp Twist. If I'd known what was going on, I'd have turned back right away, believe me. But I didn't know. And so I rode farther and farther away from my beloved little people and the dismal future Count Warp Twist had planned for them.
Hear ye! Hear ye! The land of Mother Goose shall henceforth be called the land of Warp Twist. All citizens are subject to the command of the Crooked Count and his knights. Signed, King Cone.
Little Jack Horner sat in a corner eating his Christmas pie. He stuck in his thumb and pulled out a plum.
Ooh. Hey, what a big boy am I!
You're gonna have to be plenty, plenty big from now on. What? Thanks.
What's wrong?
What isn't wrong? Terrible news from all over the country. The crooked knights are swooping down and carrying off all the moms and dads to work in the mines.
That's awful.
Oh, my gosh. Look.
Mom! Dad!
Oh, no! Help! Help!
Another slave!
Somebody, help!
Take up to the mines.
Stop! Stop!
Shall we take this one?
Nah, he's too puny.
Now what am I gonna do? No more mom and dad? No house?
Oh, don't cry, Jack. There's always hope. Someday, Mother Goose will return. Then everything will be right again.
But that may be too late.
It's never too late to start all over again. To push back the hands on Big Ben. No clock in the world has the right to say it's too late today. 'Cause it's never too late to start all over again. The world's going round again. No cookie cuckoo has the right to say it's too late today, 'cause it's never too late. It's never too late.
It's never too late.
To start all over again.
It's never too late.
To push back the hands on Big Ben.
It's never too late.
No clock in the world has the right to say
it's too late today.
too late.
It's never too, too late.
No, it's never too late.
It's never too, too late.
It's never too late.
Things look brighter now?
A little, but I still don't know where I'm going to live from now on.
Hmm, that is a problem. Thank you. Maybe I know where you can stay.
Hunter remembered old Mrs. Hubbard, the woman who lived in a shoe. Good Mrs. Hubbard had taken in all the children whose parents were stolen by Count Warptwist.
There was an old woman who lived in a shoe. She had so many children.
I just don't know what to do.
You see, she was having a terrible time of it. There was no curds and whey for Miss Muffet, no pies for Simple Simon, and no pickled peppers for Peter Piper.
Well, at least there's a bone here for you.
Old Mother Hubbard went to the cupboard to get her poor dog a bone. But when she got there, ooh, and so the poor dog had none.
Mrs. Hubbard's last hope was that Mary had grown some nice vegetables in her garden. But to her anguish, Mrs. Hubbard discovered that instead of vegetables, Mary had grown...
flowers!
I just didn't feel like growing vegetables.
Mary, Mary, quite contrary. How does your garden grow?
With silver bells and cockle shells and pretty...
We can't eat pretty things. Last night I had to serve broth without any bread. Tonight we'll all go to bed hungry. Oh, dear me. What to do? What to do?
Gee, I didn't mean... I thought flowers were prettier.
You're always doing everything opposite from the way people want.
Why can't we just go to the market and buy food?
Because there's no food to be had. Count Warptwist is keeping everything for himself and his knights.
I think that's just horrid of him. We should do something. But I guess nothing can be done.
That's a girl for you.
Well, can you do anything?
Sure.
What, Smarty?
I can go and get a message to Mother Goose, and then she'll come back. Then all our moms and dads will be set free, and we'll have plenty to eat.
Oh, you're just bragging. I think boys are the worst braggarts in the world.
I'm not bragging.
How can you get to her, Smarty Pants? She's way up beyond the moon.
I don't know how, but I'll find her some way.
Ha ha. When are you going to start?
Right now. Who wants to live in an old shoe?
Oh, let me come too, please.
No, this is no job for sissies or girls.
Think that's going to stop me?
You're a brave little feller, Jack. Good luck, boy. What? We're all counting on you.
Goodbye, Humpty.
So Jack set out to find me. And it was rough going right from the start. For what he didn't realize was that the evil Count Warptwist had made the roads all twisty and crookedy so that nobody could find their way anywhere. Soon Jack was hopelessly lost. And although he tried not to show it, he was very, very scared.
It's only me. I thought you were so brave.
What are you doing down there?
I followed you.
Oh, good grief.
It's too late to turn back. You have to take me along with you.
I guess she's right. But how did this happen? But look, don't you start acting like a girl or anything. I mean, don't start getting scared.
Look who's talking.
A snake! Just a little old earthworm.
I don't think that's at all funny, Jack Horner. Here, help me down.
Jump down yourself.
Jumping isn't ladylike.
Oh, for crying out loud.
Thank you, Jack.
Boy, out of everybody in the world, why did I have to get stuck with a girl?
Oh, I think you're lucky. Everybody knows girls are better than boys.
Boys are better.
Girls.
Boys!
Gotta give us half a chance. Let us know just where we stand. Don't keep us in suspense. Please dispense with being coy. Learn how to act with a boy. All we ask is half a chance. From a boy, half a chance. All we ask is half a chance. You ought to give us half a chance. Let us have our girlish wins. You win out in the end. Just depend on chivalry. Learn to agree with a girl. All we ask is half a chance. From a boy, half a chance. All we ask is half a chance. You ought to give us chance. Let us know just where we stand. Don't keep us in suspense. Please dispense with being coy. Learn how to act with a boy. Learn to agree with a girl. All we ask is half a chance.
Come on and see if you can keep out of trouble.
And so they started off again, this time together. But the roads were even more twisted than before, and they walked for hours and hours. Suddenly Mary stopped and said,
"We don't seem to be getting anywhere."
"Stop complaining.
Can't we rest for a minute?"
"Well, I guess a minute won't hurt." Whew.
"What kind of nights are we?
Hey, did you hear that?
What?
Listen. The nights. They're coming this way. We've got to hide."
"Where?"
"Quick, make a dash for that big mulberry bush over there."
"Dire. Well, what kind of guys are we? Bad guys.
Bad, oh, shh. Bad guys. Something what just tickled my feet. Oh, it's a little lamb."
"Gee whiz, where'd he come from?"
"What kind of nights are we?
Crooked nights. And what are we up to?
No good.
What work do we do?
Dirty work.
Our design shall be..."
"All clear. Look, he's following me. Isn't he cute?"
"Well, we can't take him along. Go home." "Oh, boy. Come on, we can't stay here any longer. Now be quiet. Those knights are everywhere."
"Mary had a little lamb, little lamb, little lamb. Mary had a little lamb whose fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, Mary went, Mary went. Everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go."
"Oh, no.
What can I do? He won't stop following me."
"I guess we'll just have to take him along." "But be quiet. Now, come on.
Jack, look over there. It's the same mulberry bush."
"It couldn't be. We've been walking for miles."
But it was. You see, the roads were so twisted that they'd just been going round and round the mulberry bush. They realized they'd never get anywhere if they stuck to the roads, so they cut out across the fields. And soon they came to a rough and angry river.
Wow! Sure looks mean. We can't swim across that. We'd be washed away. I'll think of something. Will you be quiet? Look! Georgie Porgie's ferry. Hey, I know how we can get across. We'll take the ferry. How did you ever think of that? Oh, come on. Will you take us across?
You got the fare?
How much?
Either a pudding or a pie.
We don't have a pudding or a pie.
Okay, then give me a kiss instead.
No!
I want a kiss. You come across or I don't take you across.
No, no, no!
Hey, you stop!
Georgie Porgie pudding and pie kissed the girls and made them cry. When the boys came out to play, Georgie Porgie ran away.
Meow!
Oh, Jack, you saved me.
Shucks, I couldn't let him talk that way to a girl.
Hey, see them? They're trying to get across the river without paying. I bet they're up to no good.
We'll see about that. Think we got a couple of traitors. This way.
This way, get them. After them. Get them. We gotta get away.
Look, the crooked knights.
Come on, make a dash for it.
We're trapped. They'll get us in a second.
Oh, if only Mother Goose was here. She'd know what to do. Do you think Mother Goose knows what's happening? I hope she does. I hope she can help us.
I guess Jack hoped really hard, for as I was sitting with my sister on her front porch, way beyond the moon, I suddenly got the strangest feeling. I felt I was needed back home. But my sister said,
if you're worried, why can't you send down a little magic to hold them over, just in case there is any trouble?
I suppose that would do for the time being. Oh, I do hate to leave you, sister dear.
Mary, look!
Rub-a-dub-dub, three men in a tub, and who do you think they are?
The butcher.
The baker.
The candlestick maker.
And they all came down on a star.
Maybe they'll give us a ride.
Help! 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 Take us with you.
Well, of course we'll.
Help! That's why we're
here, didn't you know?
That?
Okay, Mary, let's go.
Get him!
Welcome to the SSBBC, as proud a ship as you will ever see, commissioned in the year of 33, without the blessing of Her Royal Majesty. Welcome to the SSBBC,
to tell the truth, we've never actually seen a single member of the Queen's Night Fleet.
Never been to war or even been to sea. Yes, we're the ruddy BBC, butcher, baker, candlestick maker, we.
A
non-commercial vessel, you must agree.
An arty fit for cargo or humanity.
Welcome to the SSVBC, as proud a ship as you will ever see. Commissioned in the year of 33, without the blessing of Her Royal Majesty.
Mention it.
Chum, glad to be of
service.
Bye. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the ride.
Shouldn't we look for a place to sleep now? I mean, it's getting dark and spooky.
No, time to stop. We've got to keep going.
I'm hungry, too.
Hey, look! Our troubles are over! Here comes Mother Goose!
Hooray!
Hooray, hooray for Mother Goose!
Hey, that's not Mother Goose.
And indeed it wasn't. It was the terrible Goosey Gander, a personal friend of Count Warptwist.
It's after us! Run!
It's got my lamb. Oh, Jack, save it. Save it.
Grab my legs, Mary, and pull. Okay, now let go.
Just fine.
Anna, don't get mushy.
Oh, Jack, you're a hero. I'm sorry I said all those awful things about you.
No time for that, Mary. It's coming back. Run! I don't think it can see us here.
Uh-oh. What is it now?
Look up ahead. Those knights are all over the place.
But we can't run back. Goosey Gander will get us.
Quick, hide in that pumpkin patch over there.
Oh, the knights on one side, Goosey Gander on the other. What will we do?
Well, we're safe here.
What's that?
I think it's a ghost.
Oh.
We're surrounded.
It looked as if Jack and Mary were done for. Meanwhile, the crooked count was growing more and more powerful.
Zigzag, did you feed our prisoners?
I didn't have the heart. They're starving so. They just might eat that awful stuff.
Do as you are told.
I can't bear to look.
Cold peas porridge again?
Uh-huh. 9 days old.
I hope you choke on it. Now, if the princess would be a bit more friendly, perhaps I could arrange finer fare.
Never!
That a girl!
What?
Nothing. I kind of like the stuff. Really?
You wouldn't be like this if Mother Goose came back.
If ifs and ands were pots and pans, there'd be no need for tinkers.
Hey, that's pretty good. I must remember it for the squire's banquet.
Shut up and come with me.
Yes, sir, Count Whipwurp. Wristwatch.
Oh, quiet. Don't. Now come with me.
Don't be blue, Princess. things will get better.
How can you be sure?
Well, they can't get worse.
Oh, Robin, I just knew that you were going to say something predictable like that.
I don't need a crystal ball to look into your heart. I knew what you were and how you would act right from the very start. I can predict when you're in the mood for me, dear. From one of your smiles, my feminine wiles tell all to me. Can't you see my intuition can predict what your disposition will be? 'Cause when you're with me, you're predictable as can be.
If we meet at 8, I know I'll be kissed at 10, dear. From one of your sighs, the look in your eyes will tell me when. And once again, your inspirations have come in clear as your conversations you see. 'Cause when you're with me, you're predictable as can be. Couldn't you try to be unpredictable just once?
But what had become of Jack and Mary? Oh, they were in a terrible predicament. With the knights on one side of them and Goosey Gander on the other. And right beside them in the pumpkin patch, a ghost.
We can't just stay here with a ghost. But we can't leave, either. Ooh. Hey, look! It's not a ghost. Somebody's inside that pumpkin.
Oh, help me to get out of this pumpkin shell, please.
Who are you?
My name is Patricia. My husband, Peter Pumpkin Eater, put me in here. Help me out.
Peter Pumpkin Eater had a wife and couldn't keep her. Put her in a pumpkin shell and there he kept her very well.
Why'd your husband put you in there?
Because he's turned very cruel lately. And I tried to run away. What are you doing here?
We're hiding.
Oh, how sad. That's what everyone seems to be doing nowadays. You look cold and hungry. Oh, please come home and have supper with me. You mustn't think badly of my husband. Once he was a good and kind man, but he's changed so since he became one of Warp Twist's knights.
One of what? Oh, boy, we better get out of here.
No, he won't be back till morning. Oh, yes, certainly you may have some more pumpkin pie. You see, Warp Twist puts a spell on his knights and makes them twisted and cruel and evil. It's just terrible, I tell you. Terrible.
Gee, no wonder you keep trying to run away.
My life's not my own since Peter became a prisoner of Warp Twist's powers. Why, the Count has his spies everywhere.
Spies?
Yes. He uses his magic powers to turn common household articles into spies. You never know what's listening to you.
Huh?
Once it was my hat rack. Another time, my tea kettle. You see, they watch you. And then they run and tattle to him.
Well, are there any spies here now?
I think I cleared them all out.
Oh, but Patricia hadn't cleared all the spies out of her house. For just that morning, Count Warp Twist had sneaked in a simply awful dish and spoon.
Oh, dear. With all Warp Twist's knights and evil powers, we'll never get to Mother Goose. There must be some way to go beyond the moon.
I know a way.
You do?
I could ride there on Mother Goose's purple cow.
What cow?
The famous one, who can jump over the moon.
Yeah, sure. But why didn't you do that before?
I tried, but the cow is getting old and she's very temperamental.
Maybe if we all tried to persuade her, she'd take you. Where is she?
I can take you there, and if you can make her jump, I'll ride her up to Mother Goose.
Then what are we waiting for? Let's go! Oh, please.
No, no, I'm not in the mood.
Well, what will put you in the mood?
Music.
Music? Where will we get music?
I know. Her accompanist must be nearby. Here, Pussy! Here, Pussy!
A cat? Good grief.
Who's calling me? Doggone it, I'm sleeping.
Oh, you've got to fiddle a tune so the cow will jump.
Nope, don't feel like it. Y'all had no business waking me up.
Who's that?
It's me.
I didn't know dogs climb trees.
Oh, don't pay any attention to him. He's always hanging around here pestering me.
Yeah, that old cat won't fiddle, because he don't know how to no more.
Do too?
You do not.
Do too.
Then let's hear you. He can't fiddle a darn.
You just listen. Anything worse than a smarty cat, it's a smarty dog. Watch this here.
Is she safe?
Yes, but if you wish her to stay that way, you shall sign this new proclamation. It gives everything to me.
Everything?
Everything.
Isn't that a bit much?
You shall sign it or else.
I'll sign it. Very well. Give it to me. Good gracious. The royal dishwasher must be getting careless.
Leave them alone. What? The cow? Mother Goose? Curses! This calls for drastic action. We must get those dratted children before Mother Goose returns. We'll use them as hostages. Zigzag!
Right here, Count Whitworth. What rope?
Don't! Sound the alarm, summon all my knights. Our number one objective is to get those kids.
And soon each and every one of the Crooked Count's terrible knights marched forth. Their one objective was to
get those kids! Get those kids!
Poor Jack and Mary. It certainly looked hopeless for them. Their one hope was that Patricia could get to me in time, but she had such a long way to go.
Faster, faster.
I'm doing my best.
Those kids,
Get those kids! Get those kids!
They mean us! Oh, Jack. Jack, they're all around us. We haven't a chance.
You think you can make a run for it?
I'll try.
You're okay, Mary. For a girl, I mean. Okay, let's go.
There they go. After them.
Yeah, all right, get them. Get them, 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 get them,
get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them, get them,
the others.
Mary! Oh my gosh! We went over a cliff! Help!
They're goners. It's miles to the bottom of that cliff. They'll be smashed to pieces.
Good. Let's take the girl back to Warp Twist.
So you are all that is left of the pack of brats who have been causing me all this trouble, eh? Well, I have a special cell for you. Way down in the sub-sub-basement. You'll never get out of here. Now stay there until you rot. And just to make sure you won't escape, Brutus! This candlestick will be your jailer. If you try to escape, he can make it pretty hot for you. Hey, Brutus?
Oh, help me! Someone help me! Oh, Jack, what happened to you? You can't be dead. You just can't be.
Poor Mary. If only she could have known. When Jack and the lamb fell over the edge of the cliff, they weren't hurt. You see, they had the very good fortune to land in Little Boy Blue's soft haystack. Thank goodness Boy Blue wasn't under it, fast asleep at the time. For once, he was where he should be, out guarding his livestock.
Boy, he'll never blow that horn again. Don't worry, little feller. We'll find Mary and get her back. But how? Where is she?
Jack! Jack Horner!
Who's that?
Me. I've been looking all over for you.
Humpty! What are you doing here?
I couldn't just sit there on a wall and let a little boy try and save the land. This is the time when everybody's got to fight for what's right. Right? Right.
Good for you, Humpty. The knights just captured Mary, and I've got to save her. Mother Goose may not get back in time.
Where is she?
That's the trouble. I don't know how to find her.
Give it a go. Give it a try. Give it a whirl. Give it a whack. You never know. You just might have the knack. Give it an ounce. Give it a bounce. Give it a smack. Get a handle on this great big wacky world.
That's it. That lamb is sure to go wherever Mary goes, isn't he?
Uh-huh.
Well, just set him free to follow her, and we'll follow him, right?
Right.
Give it a go, give it a try, give it a whirl, give it a whack, you never know. You just might have the knack. Give it an ounce, give it a bounce, don't be a goose, take a gander at this great big whack.
Little feller, you can find her if anybody can. Please, please.
We're with you.
There it is, right up ahead. I think I can see her. Oh, Mother Goose! Mother Goose!
Mother Goose!
But they were still much too far away for me to hear them. Meanwhile, Jack was doing his best to get to Mary before anything terrible happened to her. Humpty's idea worked splendidly. The little lamb led them directly to Count Warptwist's mansion.
Whoops! Shh! Keep down!
I have a hard enough time keeping up. Not as young as I used to be. Yoke trouble.
You did a good job, little feller.
Now the trick is to get inside.
Wait a minute. Here comes somebody.
Bang the gong, call the knights, serve the porridge, sweep the floor. Sometimes I feel like fitting. I feel like quitting.
It's Warptwist Squire. I have an idea. Listen, how is this going
to... I'll try.
Gadzooks, it's Horton Jacker, John Hacker.
Jack Horner!
Right!
Now, quick, get into his clothes.
Out cold to catch. Catch a cold. Too curved. Ka-choo.
Quiet. Okay, Jack, let's see.
Doing my hound. How am I doing? Count with Wartop?
That's pretty good. Try not to show your face. Now get moving.
Good morning. Good morning.
Zigzag. Zigzag, zigzag. Where is that fool squire? Zigzag!
Coming.
Where have you been, dolt?
Nowhere, Count Twitford. Tart first.
Oh, how could you be nowhere? Oh, never mind, never mind. Don't answer that. It is now time to feed the prisoners, and this time make them eat their porridge.
Yes, sir, Count Dumptwerp, Twistfist.
And the minute you are through, report to me. I have more dirty work for you to do.
I refuse to eat that. Why, you're not Zigzag.
Shh, I'm Jack Horner, Your Highness.
Jack Horner? Say, I've always wanted to meet you, feller.
Shh, Your Highness.
I say something wrong? I used to play quoits with your father.
Shh, please. Ma'am, do you know where he's keeping Mary?
Yes, down that second flight of stairs. But you'll never get her out past that terrible candlestick.
I've got to try. Here, this is the key to your cell. But don't come out until I give you the signal.
Oh, bless you, Jack.
Sir, here's the key to your cell. But don't come out till I give you the signal.
Oh, this is exciting. Could you, quick thinking, little feller. Oh, hey, Jack. You forgot to give me my peas porridge.
Just bring it in the brood, or bring it in the food.
No. No, I don't want any.
Oh! Shh! Now, when I tell you, Mary, we make a run for it.
Oh, Jack, I thought you were dead. Oh, I'm so frightened.
I'll get you out. I promise. Now, ready?
Hey, Jack! I forgot to ask! What's the signal?
Oh, no.
I say something wrong?
We're done for, Jack. This time we're really done for.
No, we can't give up now. We've got to get out of here.
But how?
Yes, it looked like the end for poor Jack and Mary. But fortunately, Patricia got to me just in time. She told me what was happening, and I was furious. Let me tell you, just furious. Why, that's terrible. I've got to get back there this instant.
Oh, please hurry.
Bedelia! Away, Bedelia! Away!
She's on her way at last.
Ooh-rah! Ooh-rah!
It's Mother Goose to the rescue.
Faster, Bedelia, faster!
I've got to get us out of here. We can't get around that old candle, but maybe...
Jack, be nimble, Jack, be quick. Jack, jump over the candlestick.
That's it! Trust me, Mary, quick!
Is that the signal?
Yes!
Just like to keep things straight.
Come on!
Run, 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 watch out!
Come on,
come on,
we're trapped!
Not yet! Grab this rope.
Good work, Humpty.
Humpty, look out!
Huh?
Oh, Humpty!
You go on, kids. I'm done for.
No.
It's no use.
Oh. He's... Oh, no.
You've all had it now, including this old fool.
Father!
My darling daughter.
Oh, Father, I thought I'd never see you again.
There, my dear. There.
And don't try any funny business. My knights are surrounding you.
Faster, Bedelia, faster. We're almost there. Tally-ho!
And now to do away with all of you before Mother Goose can save you. Brutus! Burn them to a crisp, a lot of them.
Good heavens, that's terrible.
Don't just stand there. Do something, you waxy dolt.
Dear Rain, Rain, go away. Come again some other day.
Ah, you're fired. Curses on you, Mother Goose. I shall fight you on your own territory.
What's he doing?
Look, it's Goosey Gander.
Up, up and away.
He's right behind you!
Take that!
Oh, dear me, but that was a close one. So he wants to fight, does he? Oh. Oh, how terribly annoying. Bedelia.
Curses! Curses on everything!
And that's that.
The spell has taken off us. We're normal again.
Three cheers for Mother Goose!
Hooray! Hooray! Hooray!
Hey, the good guys won. Hooray! Hey, look at me. I'm disenchanted.
Oh, everything will be the way it used to be. Our parents will come home. We'll all be friendly again. Oh, isn't it all wonderful?
Yeah, except for...
Oh, gee, I almost forgot.
Yes, he's beyond help. All my horses and all my men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty together again.
Oh, stuff and nonsense. I've got something all those horses and men don't have. Good hot magic soup.
Delicious. Hey, look. I'm all better.
Hooray!
You're better than better.
Huh? What?
My pipe, my bowl, my fiddler's tree.
And I'll never run away from you again, Peter.
Isn't it all beautiful?
My blessings on you both.
Dearest.
My darling. Doggone. Thank you for your blessings, sir.
You'll need them.
Oh, now, now, now.
Oh, Mother Goose. We all love you so.
What would we do without you?
Oh, stuff and nonsense. It was your bravery that really saved the day. Oh, it's so good to be back home. Now go. Enjoy the fun. Hmm? What's that? You say you must be going. Oh, well, yes, I suppose it is getting late. Oh, I'm so sorry to see you go. I hope you liked our wacky world. And you see, everything turned out so nice in the end, just like a fairy tale. All stories can have a happy ending in this great big wacky world. Well, make up your own. Go on. Give it a try, love. Give it a try.